Hi, how are you? It's Diane Banks, voice actress and radio personality in Chicago. Please take a second to subscribe. And my other videos, I've got over 250 for you now, waiting for you to take a peek, including Disney's Disney World, A Great Movie Ride, Universe of Energy, Were Those Closings a Mistake? That's one of my most recent, along with Food Fun, Amy's Kitchen's new barbecue pizza, the unboxing and review. Yum! Yeah, mostly I do Disney videos, but on occasion I do other videos that you guys like foodie stuff. So hopefully you'll take a peek at those. And yes, please subscribe. So we got to talk about Disney hotel toiletries today, a topic I never thought I'd be doing. Thanks to Walt Disney World Info for the scoop on this. What's happening is they're testing out shared toiletries. So yes, you know these cute little goodies that we get to take home? They could be a thing of the past where they're going to have the kind that are on the wall. Now, some hotels do this already where you get like the big bottles that are stuck to the wall and you share them. I know health clubs do that, but I don't know about this one. But anyway, the scoop here is that they're testing different ways of providing the bath products, large bottles of their H2O products, which are these guys, mounted to the shower wall at certain resorts to stop the saving of those adorable little bottles and mini soaps. The floating around photos are showing what appears to be a locking contraption. It covers the part where the top comes off so they can't be tampered with by other guests, but a lot of posters are saying they're concerned about that, they don't want to do it because somebody could break the seal and who knows what would be in there. And then another person says, I've noticed too many people leaving their bathroom at Disney and they don't wash their hands. I don't want to think about them touching my shared shower soap. And then somebody else says, I stayed at a high-end hotel and I liked it. I could use as much stuff as I wanted with those convenient pumps. And because of those little bottles, sometimes this stuff is hard to get out. Now, it looks like where they're testing this right now is at Port Orleans Resort Riverside. And I don't know if it's going to become a future thing or not. But I thought I'll give you a couple of these comments, and then I want to know what you guys think. But somebody else here says, I don't think it cheapens the experience. It saves the company money. And yeah, let's face it, it's probably why they're doing it. And it's also better for the planet. Let's see, somebody else here says there's a lot of waste with products, so it's a good idea. And then here's kind of what I'm thinking. Absolutely hate the idea. Almost consider half-used items as souvenirs. Help me bring home the magic. Amen. Somebody else says, gives me a warm feeling remembering our fond past trips. So I want to know what you guys think. I don't like it. I mean, yes, I know it would help the environment, but I do reuse the stuff. I still have some of these little bottles from old trips, and they're adorable. Like they said, bring home the magic. Now, maybe it's a girl thing, I don't know. But like these bottles here, when I'm done using the shampoos, I take these on other trips, even if it's not Disney, because they're small and they fit that, you know, the 3-ounce rule. So I put other lotions and things in them and they get reused. And then you open your suitcase and you got these cute little mouse ears. And then these are some of the older ones. Like I said, I still have some of those bottles because they're so darn cute. Now, I haven't been to the parks in a couple years, so are they using these now in the H2O in the hotels? The last time I was there, they had these. So let me know if you've been recently and if those are still the soaps they're using in the hotels. But like I said, I want to know what you guys think in the comments. Are you cool with the idea of sharing your toiletries with other hotel guests? Or are you like me where part of the magic is taking home these little cuties? Which, by the way, I'm so much that way. I was upset when they stopped making Disney napkins. You know, like when you go to the restaurants and eat out, and even the fast food, they had those cute little theming on the napkins, like Halloween and all that stuff, and they don't do that anymore. So, I don't know. Like I said, really, really want your thoughts on this, whether the sharing is a good idea or bad. And I don't know whether it's going to go wide or not, but let's get to your comments real quick and before we wrap up today. So over on Instagram, I'm at banks.diane if you want to follow me. From my video about celebs rocking Disney Mickey Mouse t-shirts, Reekin Havoc, I love that, that's cute. Reekin Havoc says, very nicely done, thank you. And then we'll grab one more here and then get to your comments on YouTube. Let's see, my video about Disney's new summer frozen fun treats. Yum, yum. A comment here from Janelle Ledge. She says, "This is amazing. Thanks, you guys. Very sweet of you over on Instagram." And then here on YouTube, our longtime friend Clay Carmichael watched my video about Amy's Kitchen, the one I talked about the barbecue pizza, and says, "Congrats on winning. I'm not vegan or vegetarian, but I want to know, is it difficult trying to eat vegan at Disney?" You guys want to comment on that too? I'd love to hear your comments there. I think it kind of is. I wish they had regular menu choices more so than having to ask for things, either vegan or vegetarian, but that's just my thoughts. So, lots of things for you guys to comment on today. And wow, like I said, never thought I'd be doing a video about toiletries, but it's an interesting topic for sure. So, it's Diane Banks. Thanks as always for watching. Please subscribe, and we'll talk soon.